In this video, we will review Section 5 of the ENERGY STAR Multifamily New Construction Functional Testing Checklist. We will be using Revision 4 of this checklist, but please check the ENERGY STAR website for the latest applicable version. Section 5 covers the installation and functional testing of indoor or terminal units for heating and cooling equipment. This section must be completed for all heating and cooling equipment located within dwelling units or common spaces. Indoor or terminal units include, but are not limited to, traditional split ACs and heat pumps, as well as mini-split heat pumps, multi-split heat pumps, PTACs or packaged terminal air conditioners, PTHPs, packaged terminal heat pumps, water loop heat pumps, fan coils, and hydronic distribution systems, among the many possible types. Section 5 of the ENERGY STAR Multifamily New Construction Functional Testing Checklist includes two main subsections, 5.1 for installation checks, and 5.2 for functional testing. 5.1.1 is looking for the zone thermostat in the dwelling units. We're going to check that there is a thermostat in the dwelling unit and that the thermostat is in the location that the HVAC unit serves. For items 5.2.1, through 5.2.3, we're going to check that the thermostat is functioning correctly and measures the right temperature. And we're going to see that it does indeed turn the unit on in both heating and cooling modes. To complete section 5.2.1, we're going to want equipment that is calibrated and can accurately measure the dry bulb temperature of the room. You're going to want it about 4 feet above the floor in the middle of the room, or near the thermostat or temperature measuring device. Let it acclimate to the room temperature. Once it hits the steady state, confirm that it's within 5 degrees Fahrenheit of what the thermostat or temperature sensor is reading. Sections 5.2.2 and 5.2.3 for functional testing, I want to confirm that the system turns on when there's a call for heating or cooling, and that it turns off when the set point has been met. First, I locate the dwelling unit or common space thermostat and confirm it's in the correct mode. I'm going to change it to heating mode, and I'm going to turn up the thermostat a few degrees. I now want to confirm that the unit does turn on when there is this call for heating, and I can feel warm air coming out of the registers. I now want to confirm that the heat turns off when the set point is met. I can do this by reducing the set point below the current temperature and observing that the thermostat is no longer calling for heat and that there no longer is warm air coming out of the register. I'm then going to change to cooling mode and run the same steps. I'm going to turn the temperature down and confirm that the system does indeed turn on in cooling mode and cold air is coming out of the ducts. And then I'm going to increase the set point above the current temperature to confirm the system turns off and cold air is no longer coming out of the ducts. When these sections have been completed, we can mark the appropriate checkbox in the columns on the right. There are some exceptions to these sections where someone may mark NA or not applicable for certain reasons. It may be due to high or low ambient temperature or equipment lockout due to the ambient temperature. If this is the case, you can mark the appropriate box, but also confirm that you're getting the builder or developer to provide signed documentation acknowledging the component of the functional testing was not completed due to the temperature lockout or equipment safety lockouts. Section 5.2.4 is applicable where an outdoor air inlet or duct is connected to the dwelling unit HVAC system. For this section, we should confirm a motorized damper is installed that closes when there's no call for ventilation or when the fan is off. First, we locate the outdoor air damper and confirm we understand where the indicator is for the open and closed positions. We then confirm that it's open when there is a call for outdoor air, and that it does close when there's no call for outdoor air or when the fan is off. And that completes Section 5 of the ENERGY STAR Multifamily New Construction Functional Testing Checklist. All applicable boxes have been checked by the appropriate party for all applicable HVAC systems. If you have any questions or would like more information, you can use this contact information or go to the ENERGY STAR website. Thank you.